risotto. Hi everyone, welcome back. It's so nice to see you here. Welcome to my channel. Instead of using some fake hair, I decided to crimp my hair today. I just bought a crimper. I hadn't had one for ages, and so I burnt my finger. So I have a blister now and it hurts. I'm gonna try and enjoy my natural hair as much as possible. Since I'm thinking of getting rid of the green, I think I'm gonna try a different color. I love dark green very much. I think it has been my favorite hair color so far, but it's time for a change, so I'm gonna try something else. If you guys have any suggestions, please let me know in the comments. What do you think it's the color that would suit me best? Let me know. I would actually really appreciate some different opinions, so yeah. Okay, so today's video is all about my Instagram followers, so if you're not following me on Instagram, go follow me there. I have the same username everywhere. So I asked you guys on my Insta stories if you could help me on my next video, which is this video, by helping me pick my makeup or a few steps of my makeup or the theme of my makeup. So I'm gonna show you the questions and I'm gonna show you your answers. The first question I asked was high-end or drugstore. So I wasn't very specific about what the question was related to, okay, to keep a bit of mystery and to be more interesting for both of us. And this is for my foundation, my concealer, my primer, so basically the base of the makeup. So you guys picked drugstore with 62%. So I'm gonna do everything drugstore. I'm gonna use the Angel Veil by NYX. So I think this is like the favorite of most people when it comes to primers by NYX. I really like this one, but I really like the Honey Do Me Up as well. But since I'm always using that one, I'm just gonna change a little bit and I'm just gonna use the Angel Veil today. Now I'm gonna use foundation. I'm gonna use the Makeup Revolution Stick Foundation. This is the lightest color, F1. This is pretty much the foundation that I use every day when I wear foundation. It's not super high coverage, so if you want a little bit more coverage, you can layer it up. And for concealer, I'm gonna use the NABLA Close Up Concealer. I'm not sure if this is considered drugstore, probably not. It's a little bit more pricey compared to the other stuff I just use in my face, but it's not incredibly expensive. I would use the Makeup Revolution Concealer, but I don't have it anymore. It's just so tiny. It doesn't have that much product, so mine is over, so I cannot use it anymore. Alright, foundation and concealer done, so let's go to the next two options. So I asked you to choose between cream or powder, and I was talking about contour, so you chose powder, 54%, so let's use some powder to contour. I'm actually gonna use something new. This is from Stargazer, the Contour Palette Define and Sculpt. This was sent to me by My Spooky Vanity, which is a French store. So if you guys live in Europe, they have a bunch of brands, more like alternative, indie, cruelty-free makeup. Stargazer is just one of them, but I have My Pretty Zombie, Monster Cosmetics, Parfum Noir, a lot of stuff, including accessories as well. So check them out. It's great for us to have more American brands being sold in Europe because it's just a lot cheaper. This is a black and white contour palette, which I was really excited about because I don't think I've ever saw like a true monochromatic black and white contour palette. These are not super pigmented. I've tested them out already. So this is the black, this is the gray, and this is the white, which you can barely see because it's a little bit more like a setting powder. I was a little bit disappointed about it because I thought it was gonna be highlighter, blush, and contour, but I think these two work a little bit more like contour. The gray one is definitely has a kind of shimmer to it. The black is matte and the white is just matte white and pretty much transparent, so you can use it as a setting powder, which I will. Very good for your extreme goth looks. I'm gonna try with the gray first. I think this works a little bit better if you have, whoa, a more like theatrical, dramatic kind of look. As you can see, you don't need a lot. I just like dipped my brush barely. I don't think I'm gonna need to use the black because this seems to be pretty dark already. And I'm gonna use the white part just to set everything else. Let's move on to some highlighter. Here's kind of an extreme option. This is the NYX Lingerie, Lid Lingerie actually. So this is a super frosty white. It's called White Lace Romance. I'm gonna swatch it here so you guys can see. Oh, there you go. This is meant to go on your lids, but I like to use it as an highlighter. You just need to be careful because it dries really quickly. So just go little by little, like this, and then I like to blend it with my finger. Like, this is incredibly vibrant, and I think it's such a cool option for really pale skin. Next question was blush or freckles, and you guys chose freckles, 57%. I think I'm gonna save the freckles for last. If it was blush, I would do it now, but since it's freckles, I think I will save them for later so I can decide what color with my freckles. So let's see the next step. Eyebrows or no eyebrows? You guys massively voted for eyebrows, 76%, which is fine for today because I actually haven't shaved my eyebrows in a couple of days. As you can see, I have tiny little eyebrows growing now, but I was a bit surprised. It doesn't seem you guys like my no brows look that much, which kind of makes me a little bit sad because I like not having eyebrows. You guys want me to draw some eyebrows, so I'm gonna do some eyebrows now. I think I'm just gonna do like the basic shape of the eyebrows in case I want to alter them. But I think I'm gonna use like the gray blush from the Stargazer palette. If I want to correct it later, it's gonna be a little bit easier. Extreme straight eyebrow. Extreme Spock eyebrow, that's what I feel like today. I look really angry, but I swear most of the times I'm actually nice. Basic shape done, but we'll correct them and redefine them later. So next question, I asked you to decide between Dobby or Legolas, and you guys chose Legolas by 62%. I was pretty much asking you to decide between two eyeshadows by Shiro Cosmetics. The Dobby one is kind of like a mustard yellow, it's a matte eyeshadow, and Legolas is like a duochrome, and it's amazing. It's like green and blue, and it has glitter. I'm really happy you guys chose this one. I also got the Shiro Cosmetics eyeshadows at my Spooky Vanity, so they have a bunch of Shiro eyeshadows from the Harry Potter collection, Lord of the Rings, so again, really beautiful products from a cruelty-free indie brand, so I like to support smaller brands, so go check. So okay, so this is gonna be like the base of my look, or I want this to be the star of my eye look. But obviously I cannot do an entire eye look with a shimmery duochrome eyeshadow. Let's start off with a burgundy shade. This is also by Stargazer, and this is called Gypsy Rose. I have to say the swatch of this eyeshadow is pretty underwhelming, but let's see how it performs. So I think I'm gonna zoom you guys in a little bit. Hi friends, welcome to my face. So let's use a fluffy brush. Not too bad. Not the most pigmented eyeshadow ever, but it actually looks better on the eye than what I was expecting. One other option I gave you guys was no eyeliner or extreme eyeliner, and you guys picked extreme eyeliner, thankfully. So I think I might do that step next, even before I put the Legolas eyeshadow. I think I'm gonna map out the eyeliner I want, but because I want a very precise eyeliner, I think I'm gonna try and map it out with my brow pencil from NYX. I'm not sure if this is going to work out, so it's really subtle. I get on my knees and I beg to listen to me, please. I'm not sure if you guys can really see what I did there, so I'm gonna use the Kat Von D tattoo liner. Okay, the eyeliner part is done, so I'm gonna move on to some more eyeshadows. I'm gonna use the NYX matte single eyeshadows. I'm just gonna use some more burgundies. I'm just gonna deepen the color a little bit. So I'm actually gonna go back to the lid lingerie that I used for our highlighter, and I'm gonna put it on the places that I want the eyeshadow to go. Because it's a loose eyeshadow, I need like a sticky base. I'm not sure if you can really see it, I'm just gonna lower the light here a little bit, but it's blue and green and it's really amazing. I'm gonna use some white eyeliner, put it a little bit on the corner of the eye. Okay, so my eyes are pretty much done. I'm just gonna probably add some mascara or some false lashes. Now, I asked you about the lipstick and I asked you zombies or monsters, because I was torn between the My Pretty Zombies black lipstick or between the burgundy purpley dark lipstick by Makeup Monsters, and you guys picked Monsters 58%, so I'm gonna use the Makeup Monsters lipstick, which is this one. And this is the color Maroon Masquerade. It's like an eggplant kind of color. It's really pretty. In some photos it looks red, in others it looks purple. It's the perfect mixture between the two. And it's incredibly comfortable. I really like this formula. This is my first lipstick from this brand and I love it. Okay, so we're pretty much done. I've added some false lashes, some bling bling on the corner of my eyes. I added a nose chain. Now what's missing is the freckles that you guys asked, and I just remembered that I haven't set my eyebrows yet. So my eyebrows are just gray powder at the moment. I think I'm gonna use the Liquid Catsuit by Wet n Wild. This is like a shimmery green, so I'm just gonna do that. It's time for some green eyebrows, don't you think? The thing that bothers me about this lipstick is it's not as pigmented as I wish. As I think we make a pretty badass team, because I'm liking this makeup. Yeah, it's look pretty cool. I actually think with this look a blush would look a lot cooler, because it's giving me like very strong 80 vibes. But you guys are the bosses, so I'm just gonna do some freckles. Okay guys, so this is the final look. Thank you so much for staying till the end, and thank you so much for helping me doing this. We created this together. And this is all for today. I really hope you guys enjoyed this, and I will see you next time. Bye bye!